Fly fishing is, to me, almost a religion. Fly fishing, basically, just through its normal motion, it's very simple, and it's quite enjoyable. Just being outdoors in general, I do feel a very strong connection with the environment. And there's a sense of calmness that you certainly appreciate.
Ron is widely regarded as one of BC's foremost leaders in terms of environmental flow science. That includes assessment methods in the field, and that includes setting standards that are designed to conserve our wild fish biodiversity in BC and ensure the health of aquatic ecosystems. His knowledge, his expertise, and his dedication to that task has actually found its way into the Water Sustainability Act in 2016. And Ron really was the architect behind the environmental flow prescriptions and regulations in that act.
My approach to policy in general is to set reachable goals. It's one thing to say that we ascribe to doing a better job of reducing carbon emissions or whatever, but I think in the short term to get buy-in, you really do have to set realistic boundaries and benchmarks.
Ron's had a lot of impact over his career. I think the most important is the impact he's made on his team. He's a mentor to thousands of biologists, to nations who are trying to improve their understanding of Western science and what's happening on the landscape, to decision makers who are trying to understand what's happening on the landscape and how they have to improve decisions. He also takes care of his people, of his community in the water. He is a leader in safety standards for some of the most dangerous field work, snorkel surveys.
I was doing snorkel surveys well before I was actually hired as a professional biologist. And, you know, I've kept up that routine simply because it tends to be an extremely efficient means of accounting for what's truly present in a river system.
Ron frequently uses electrofishing or electroshocking, and yes, it is what it sounds like, to do fish assessments. You are able to capture the fish, measure them, count them, and then release them back into the water body unharmed.
Would they be using the Craig flower, the colquitts?
Ron is very much committed, passionate about the natural environment, the wild fish, the habitats that sustain them. The standard that Ron has set is, well, it is exceptional, and it will be a tough act to follow for sure.
This is Ron's classroom, and Ron will spend hours standing in the middle of a riffle in the river explaining the intricacies of wild fish habitat. His ability to transfer his knowledge to the younger folks has been remarkable.
Ron is a passionate individual, and his passion and enthusiasm for fish and fish habitat inspires those around him. I suspect he gets that passion from his love for the environment, from his love of fishing, from his love of fish, and wanting to share that with those around him.
It's been an honor, actually, to have the ability to travel the province, be paid for it, but also collect useful environmental data that people are seeking.